നമസ്തേ. ഭവൻസ് വിദ്യാമന്ദർ, ലൈബ്രറി ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് പ്രൗഡ്ലി പ്രസൻസ് യു വിത്ത് എ ജൂബിലന്റ് സർപ്രൈസ്. ബിലോഡ് പേരൻസ് ആൻഡ് സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്, പ്ലീസ് വെൽക്കം ദീസ് വെരി ഇൻസ്പയറിംഗ് പേഴ്സണാലിറ്റീസ് ഫ്രം ദ അസ്റ്റൗണ്ടിംഗ് വേൾഡ് ഓഫ് ലിറ്ററേച്ചർ ഇൻ ടു യുവർ ഹോംസ് വിത്ത് എ മൈറ്റി അപ്ലോസ്. താങ്ക് യു.
Hi friends, I am Nyoni from the book The Magic of the Lost Temple. I was created by the famous writer Sudha Murthy. I am a city girl and I'm used to the routines I practice there. I was surprised at the pace of life in my grandparents' village in Karnataka, but I quickly get used to the general routines and involve myself in a flurry of activities like puppet making, organizing picnics and learning to ride a bicycle with my newfound friends there. Things get exciting when I stumble upon an ancient, fabled stepwell right in the middle of a forest near the village. Join the adventure of a lifetime in this much-awaited book by Sudha Murthy, which is heartwarming, charming, and absolutely unforgettable.
Hi all, my name is Anla Snehi Frank. Most people call me Anne. I'm familiar to you from the diary that I wrote during the Second World War. I was born as a Jewish girl on June 12, 1929 on the German city of Frankfurt. My sister Margaret was 3 years old when I was born. But at that time some problems occurred in Germany. Adolf Hitler and the Nazi parties were gaining support. Nazis hated the Jews and blamed us for the problems. Do you know, Jews have to wear a Jewish star, Jews have to hand in their bicycles, Jews are not allowed in trams, Jews are not allowed to roll in cars, Jews must attend Jewish schools and so on and so forth. Fortunately, in 1933, Adolf Hitler came into power. He decided to get rid of the Jews. So, we have to flee to Netherlands and go on hiding. Many of my friends were arrested and in the camps of Nazis. And me, hiding in Netherlands. I felt bad for lying in a warm bed, while my dearest friends are out somewhere, thrown or fallen to ground, and that just because they're Jews. I wrote all my feelings about my family, friends and everything on a diary that was gifted to me on my 13th birthday. A appeal from the Dutch government in Leiden inspired me to rework on my diary and publish a book. But before I could finish, a hiding place was discovered and even kept. Two of my helpers kept the book in the hope that I would never come back. But I did. Me and my sister Margaret died of typhus in 1945 in Bergen-Belsen concentration camp without getting any treatment. But my father survived, and when he read my diary, he understood how hard I wished to publish a book. So he fulfilled my wish. The book was read all over the world as the story of a young girl. It was translated into more than 70 languages, and my hiding place is now a museum. No one who doesn't write cannot know how fine it is. And if I don't have the talent to write for books and newspapers, well then, I can go on writing for myself. Read others' experience, write your experience and know what life is. With love, yours, Anne Frank.